Hi, everyone. Captain Bob here with some more answers to more of your questions, nature questions. I have a good supply of them, and we'll find out more about this world we live in and make a fine sketch together, too. Gather around and welcome aboard. Good to see you all again. As you know, our program deals with this wondrous world around us, and we study animal life usually, but other things too. And do I receive questions? As we go along today, see how many answers you know. I've been through this stack of mail and have information for you, so let's get right to the ones I've planned. Come on over to the drawing board. I'm sure you're all aware of that very famous insect called the mantis or mantid, and I've been asked why he's valuable to man and why his front claws are held in that peculiar upright position. Well, let's look at this giant picture I've made of one here on the drawing board, right under your nature questions. Now, we know he's not this large, but I've drawn him large so we can really see him in detail here. Look at that fella. Have you ever seen one in the garden? You'd see them on branches or leaves, and you might not know they're there because they look so much like a little twig or branch. Well, look at him close too here, and look at that head. There's his head right there, and his neck, thorax, there are those praying arms, and his body with wings. Now, this fellow right here is usually about 2.5 inches long, up to 3.5 inches long, and there are two kinds too, the Carolina or the praying mantis that I've drawn here. They're valuable because they destroy harmful insects, and thereby they help man. They can swivel their head, too. It's the only insect that I know of that can actually turn his head and look over his shoulder. Have you ever heard of an insect doing that? Well, the praying mantis can. And incidentally, never kill one of these fellows because they're so valuable to man. Questions and answers today on your nature questions. The next time we're here, more on our drawing from nature, and what will the subject be? You guess. Captain Bob, thank you for being with us. Be careful, whatever you do, and keep those eyes open, for this world around us has many wondrous things that we don't want to miss, right? I'll say so. Thanks for being with us. So long for now.
Hey! It's silly putty time! Yes, there are hours and hours of fun in the little egg that silly putty comes in. You can stretch and mold it into all kinds of funny-looking shapes, or even make crazy-looking animals. And look, you can play ball with silly putty. And see how high silly putty bounces. Or for real laughing fun, flatten silly putty into a pancake. Then press it down on a picture in a newspaper or on your favorite comic strip. And look, it picks up the picture in full color. And by stretching it, you can make it even funnier and funnier. Then just fold it together again and you're ready for another picture. You can use Silly Putty over and over again. Just put it back in the egg and save it till next time.
Silly Putty comes in a shell shaped like an egg. Silly Putty.
This is Peter Hodgson, Mr. Silly Putty himself. He's demonstrating the famous Silly Putty picture pickup to the delight of these young TV performers. They're on the soundstage at Pike Productions in Boston. Pike made the TV commercial for Silly Putty. That's credited with $25 million in sales. At Pike Productions, they work efficiently and fast to make your deadline. So, let's hear it for the next $25 million.
This is a WBZ special report. Decision 94, election night, results and reaction from Massachusetts, New England, and the nation.
Lucky duck.
I am not as good at anything as I'd like to be.
I am an eternal optimist.
I am a big fan of David Letterman.
Wow.
I am shocked by very little these days.
I am happy growing older when you consider the alternative.
I am in love with the Pacific Northwest.
I am happy being a working mom.
I'm in the greatest city to be a sportscaster.
I am one step away from buying a motorcycle to go with that helmet.
I am a big fan of Dodger dogs.
I am not Mr. Terry Murphy.
And I am everyday people.
I am definitely not a good cook.
I am KCBS LA.
Monterey, California. Around here, evening is when the work's all done. The fleet comes home, and people turn to America's most watched, most trusted news. Fair, accurate, objective. That's the CBS Evening News with Dan Rather. We keep America on top of the world.
While you are sleeping, working, relaxing, KOLO-TV 8 is preparing the studio and staff for the most comprehensive coverage of the Nevada state election. On November 4th, watch TV 8. With Fred, TV 8's new computer, you'll see the returns faster than on any other station. An operator will be standing by to answer your questions on the TV 8 update line. Tad Dunbar and Bill Brown will co-host. Tom Ainsworth will provide legislative commentary, and TV 8 eyewitness reporters will bring you up-to-the-minute information from the field. This Tuesday on TV 8.
Stand by. TV 8 holiday promo, take one. 3, 2, 1.
Happy holidays from all of us at TV 8.
It's a take.
News 4 at 6, the only local news at 6 p.m.
Happy holidays from all of us at CBS.